That is a funny story. So when I, you know, I was thinking recently, when I was in my 30s, I look back at when I started as a faculty member in my 20s, and I cringe just thinking about some of the things I did and said. And I thought to myself, I was an absolute idiot in my 20s. Then I got to my 40s, and I look back at my 30-year self and some of the things I did in my 30s, and I thought, you were an idiot in your 30s. When I got to my 50s, I looked back at my 40s, and I thought to myself, the conclusion is absolutely obvious. I gotta see that I'm an idiot. The conclusion is sad, but obvious. But I think that for me, being in the classroom has been absolutely the fun bits. I think I live for those moments, being in the classroom. My name is Martin Williams. I'm a professor in the Department of Physics at the University of Guelph, and I also moonlight as the Director of the Office of Teaching and Learning. My alma mater is Imperial College, London, and I worked at the University of Nottingham before I came to the University of Guelph in 2002, and I've been around here since then, so that's roughly 20 plus years I've been at the University of Guelph. I guess it's a serendipity in terms of how I transitioned from being a very research-focused faculty member to spending much more time thinking about teaching and learning. And that was definitely not my initial interest. I think I started out being sort of very sort of non-committal when it came to the classroom. Well, to be truthful, I just didn't like that space. I just didn't enjoy being in the classroom. But that was primarily my fault, because my understanding of teaching and learning was extremely limited. It still is, but I said, you know, the more I understand the challenges of teaching and learning, I just fell in love with students and the whole process of learning. And now I spend much more time, my research is much more focused around teaching and learning than my traditional research area, which is semiconductor physics. I felt a little bit as a sort of betrayal of, you know, proper physics for this non-traditional sort of ideas around sort of physics teaching. But I quickly realized actually that the challenges and the questions that I try to answer in physics education are definitely non-trivial and are more challenging than some of the questions that I was researching and answering in my traditional solid-state semiconductor physics area, because the samples are not very cooperative as the my samples. I think that those questions of how and why things are and are not always have kept me interested and motivated in physics. And I guess it fits my personality, wanting to know and answer those questions. So I think I got into physics because I guess I'm curious. And I've stayed in physics and stayed motivated because I think they're just more questions than answers anyway. Primarily, we're looking at two areas at the moment. Tackling the gender gap that has existed for the last 100 years, especially in North America and Europe. And on the representation of racialized minorities. And I think that a lot of students, and not just students, there are a lot of people who are keenly interested in these two areas. So that's one of my major research focus area. All the students across STEM are interested in these topics. So they're broad enough, they're not, these problems don't uniquely exist in physics. I think that the challenges of sort of gender and underrepresentation in STEM is a problem that's pervasive across all STEM disciplines. So we have students from all of the STEM disciplines from time to time who come and work with us. And it's really important because they add a perspective that sometimes it's not always accessible to us, and an understanding they bring a lens to the topic that's really unique based on their particular discipline or backgrounds, in the various groups, whether it's gender or racialized groups. And so that's really quite cool. And the second is that the intersection of technology and teaching and learning. So I think that students are very interested in technology and know more about technology. So we look at starting from class engagement systems right up to AI and how they impact teaching and learning and student learning and student success in the classroom. And that is, of a lot of interest to students. Students are keenly interested in their learning. So, but you're right, because it's the same skills. We're still, asking questions, why and why not? Because that's the bedrock of physics, of science. We constantly try to ask the questions, why or why not? Why are students learning? Why they're not learning? Why does this particular technology seem to be effective or not effective? So it's the same scientific approach, or what we like to think, we're bringing a much more scientific approach to teaching and learning than previously existed, where you just walk into the classroom and hope for the best. Our classrooms are much more controlled and designed in terms of, there are always metrics to measure the effect of what it is being done in the classroom. And when I started out, those things were never thought about, or we never really cared. Well, it's the best work environment that I've ever experienced. I think it's an amazing department. I think that, as I said before, the exceptional close bonding of the different members of the department and their care for student success and student learning, that continuous care over the years has been absolutely phenomenal. For me, it's a wonderful work environment. I get to come to work and have fun doing the things that I really like doing with the people whose company I really, really enjoy. If you find something that you're passionate about and that you're good at it also, I think it's one of the best gifts in life. You open your own doors, you make your own way. If you're really, really good and passionate at what you do, people notice and people can't help but standing up and taking notice when you walk into a room and start talking about what it is that you do. Do the things that you're good at and that you're passionate about. And you bring that enthusiasm and that joy into your work, and that shows through. And that is, to me, one of the keys to success in a career.